This tutorial will show you how to create a colorful, reflective 3D text without any plugins in After Effects. Let's get to it. Here we are in After Effects. I'm going to begin by creating a new composition. It will be at 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second, 5 seconds for the duration. And before you click OK, go into 3D settings and make sure you set the renderer to be Cinema 4D and then click OK. Then after creating the composition, let's select the type tool, then click and type something. I'll do text. You can see all of the character settings over here. I'm using Montserrat font. Then after typing the text, I'm going to switch to the selection tool. Press S on a keyboard to make the text slightly bigger. And then I'm going to align it horizontally and vertically so it is at the center. Then let's make the text layer 3D by checking this 3D icon. If you do not see it, click toggle switches and modes and then enable 3D for the text. And then we need the geometry options. And if the geometry option is grayed out for you, make sure you set the renderer to be Cinema 4D. There should be a button over here that says change renderer, so do that. After that, you will get access to geometry options, expand those and set extrusion depth to a high value. I'm going to set mine to 100. Then I'm also going to set bevel to be angular and set bevel depth to 3 to add a bevel. At this point, we can add a reflection map, and this can be any image or video. I'm going to use a simple colorful image I got from unsplash.com. Then add it below the text, press S on a keyboard and set scale to 25%. Then in effects and presets, search for motion tile and add motion tile to the image. Then in effect controls, set output width to 400 and output height to 350, or these values can be different based on the size of your image. And then make sure you check mirror edges, basically tile it until you cover entire composition. After that, let's right click on the text layer and select pre-compose. You can name this whatever you want. I'm calling mine map. Make sure you check move all attributes, click OK. Then right click on the pre-comp and select environment layer. And now in order to make the text reflect on that environment layer, we need to go into material options for the text and increase the reflection intensity to 100%. And as we do now, we get the reflection inside the text. And now if you hold the Alt key and left click and rotate the view, you can see that as we rotate the camera, the reflection map follows it as well. And if you want to have the crystal clear reflection like this, it is completely fine. Leave the sharp reflection sharpness at 100%. I prefer to have an unclear and noisy image by setting the reflection sharpness to 30%. So this is the noisy and unclear kind of look that I prefer. That is completely optional. I'm going to leave mine at 30%. At this point, we can add an adjustment layer to make the text glow. So for this, let's go up to layer, new adjustment layer. Make sure it is above the text layer. Then in effects and presets, I'm going to search for glow under stylize, add it to the adjustment layer. And then in effect controls, adjust the glow threshold. And this will be different based on the reflection map that you're using. I'm going to set mine to 50% so the text is nice and glowy. Then I'm going to select the glow, press Ctrl D to duplicate it. And for the glow 2, I'm going to set glow radius to 1000. So here we have nice glowing text. And after this, we can add the camera and animate it. So go up to layer, new camera. I'm going for these settings, 35mm preset, click OK. The view should go back to the normal. Then open the settings of the camera, go into transform. Make sure you are at the start of the timeline, then create keyframes for point of interest and position. Then select the camera orbit tool and rotate the view to your liking. I'm going to do bottom left view like this, and the keyframes are already there. Then move forward a few seconds, I'll go 3 seconds forward. And rotate the camera to get a different view. I'm just going to drag it up and get the top view. So something like this should do. I'm going to drag and select the keyframes, right click any of them, keyframe assistant, easy ease to smoothen out the animation. And now if we do the preview, this might be a bit heavy, but you get the idea, we get this kind of animation. And after animating the camera, we can add the reveal of the text at the start. So let's go back to the start of the timeline, then expand the settings of the text. Go into animate, make sure you enable pair character 3D, that is important. Then go up animate again and select scale, then set scale to 0%, open range selector, then create a keyframe for offset and set it to negative 100%, then go forward by a second, then set offset to a positive 100%, open advanced settings, set shape to be ramp up, and then set ease high to 100% and ease low to 50%. And this will give us a simple scale-up animation at the start as the whole animation happens. And the last cool thing you could add is the turbulent displace to displace and distort the text throughout the animation. So we need to do this for the adjustment layer. Search for turbulent displace in effects and presets. Add it to the adjustment layer. And then under the turbulent displace settings, we're going to set amount to 25. You can see that randomly distort the text. Then go to the start of the timeline once again. create a keyframe for evolution at 0, 0, then go to the end of the animation at 3 seconds or whatever, and then increase the evolution to 1 or 2 cycles, depends how much movement you want to have. I'm going to set mine to 1. And now, if we go ahead and do the preview, here we have a colorful, reflective 3D text created in After Effects without any plugins. Thank you guys for watching.